This is the summary for deltas. Deltas are the end of the line. In this picture of the Mississippi River and Delta in Louisiana, you can see the Mississippi River coming down here past New Orleans, just south of Lake Pontchartrain, and out to the current Birdfoot Delta down here. Deltas are sites of deposition, or sites of progradation, where we add land. What happens is that sediment is being carried in the river. When the river enters the ocean, when the water enters the ocean, it deposits sediment. Why? Well, because the velocity slows down. When the velocity slows down, the coarser material falls out of the water and you get deposition. There are several major processes that operate on a delta, three major processes: fluvial or river processes, wave processes, and tides. Here in this picture, you can see some of the major subdivisions of a delta. They're distributary channels, right here. They're distributary mouth bars, or DMBs. These are located right here. They're where the distributary channels actually enter the ocean, or the Gulf of Mexico in this case. They're delta front sheet sands, which are spread out in front of the delta here. There's the pro-delta, which is out in front of the delta. In between the distributary channels, you find interdistributary bays. Here's another block diagram that shows some additional environments on a fluvially dominated delta like the Mississippi. You have the distributary channels. You have levees, which are right next to the channels. Levees are created during flood events. They build up a mound that makes the channel bigger and can help prevent flooding. There are also crevasse splays, which are places where the levee has been breached. You can see one right here. Breaching occurs during major floods, and the sand and the water then spread out into the interdistributary bay. And you can also see the interdistributary bay. In addition, in the block diagram, you can see the various rock types and some of the features, the sedimentary structures that are found in these delta environments. There's some very important processes that operate at the distributary mouth bar and out into the pro-delta. One of the most important is the segregation of sand from mud. What happens is the sand is carried in the river over here. When it gets to the Gulf or to the ocean, velocity slows down, you deposit the sand, principally the bed load, and that's where you form the DMB. But the mud is carried out into the ocean, goes into salt water, and out there a process called flocculation causes the clay particles to clump together, and then they're deposited. So as a result, you have sand near the shoreline, but out farther you have lots of mud, and that mud has a lot of water in it. There are some large-scale delta processes that are very important. One of the first ones is progradation, or adding of land. As more and more sand is deposited, it moves out into the ocean, and eventually it will be deposited over mud. So you get sand deposition on top of mud. Now, remember that mud has a lot of water in it. You put something heavy on top of the mud, and it's going to cause compaction, and that will cause sinking. Think of a sponge with water in it. If you put something heavy like a block of wood on top of it, it's going to sink down, expel some of the water, but it's going to sink. That's sort of what happens to the mud. Now, so long as there's more sedimentation than there is sinking, you will still get progradation or adding of land. Eventually, however, the delta will build out so far that there's a shorter and steeper path to the ocean. The water will follow the steeper and shorter path. This is called avulsion. And you can see it here in this figure. Here is the original river and the delta, and then at some point, the delta, the river will avulse and seek a shorter and steeper path to the ocean, and a new delta will form. Avulsion is a very important process on deltas. But what are the consequences of this process? The major consequence is that the old delta lobe sinks and the new delta lobe forms, as seen in this figure. Why does the old delta lobe sink? Well, remember that you always have compaction on deltas because you have sand deposited on top of mud. If you're no longer getting sedimentation on the old delta because all the sediment is going to the new delta, you only have sinking. So eventually the old delta lobe will sink, but a new delta lobe will form. This map shows the positions of seven previous lobes on the Mississippi River. In the last 4,000 to 5,000 years, the Mississippi has evolved seven times with new lobes forming. So this is a very common process that operates on the Mississippi Delta.